Let's consider two examples to illustrate what we mean by debt securities issued at a discount or a premium. First, a zero coupon bond with a face value of 100 is issued for 80. The discount is 20. Second, a zero coupon bond with a face value of 100 is issued at 110. The premium is 10. The discount of 20 and the premium of 10 represent the total amount of interest to be amortized over the life of the bond on an accrual basis. A discount would result in interest of 20 being accrued over the life of the bond. The interest expense accruing in each period is recorded as being reinvested in the debt security. So it increases the principal amount outstanding. This is consistent with the accrual of interest. It is not an other economic flow in the form of a revaluation. The premium of 10 would result in accruing a reduction in interest over the life of the bond. When issued at a premium, the negative amount accruing in each period reduces the value of the bond. It also reduces interest expense. Now, how would we calculate the accrued interest resulting from the discount or the premium on a debt security? From our basic compound interest formula, we derive the interest rate to accrue the discount or premium in each period, where P equals the number of times interest accrues per year, and N equals the number of accounting periods in which interest accrues over the entire period. In other words, N is the entire period over which interest accrues. Based on this formula, we can say that the maturity value divided by the issue price to the power of 1 divided by N multiplied by P equals 1 plus the interest rate divided by P. Let's apply this formula now to our earlier example. We have a zero coupon bond with a face value and maturity value of 100. Its maturity is 5 years, so N is equal to 5. This bond is issued at a price of 80. The interest accrued from the discount on the debt security is calculated monthly, so P is equal to 12. The interest rate can therefore be calculated as follows: 100 divided by 80 to the power of 1 divided by the result of 5 multiplied by 12. This means the interest rate that we will use is 0.3726% per month. We can now calculate the outstanding principal of the bond and the accrued interest. At the beginning of month 1, the issue price is equal to 80. During the first month, interest of 0.298 accrues. This amount is reinvested in the bond, which means at the end of the first month, the value of the bond is 80.298. At the end of the second month, the total outstanding principal is 80.597, and so on. At the end of month 60, in other words, after 5 years, the value of the outstanding principal is 100. This value is equal to the par or face value. The total interest accrued from the discount on the debt security is 20, which is 100 minus 80. Note that this accrued interest of 20 excludes any possible coupon interest payments. Those would be an additional interest component of the bond if it was not a zero coupon bond. Interest accrued but not yet paid is one of the factors that determine the nominal value of a debt instrument. It does not matter whether this interest is from a discount or a premium, and or from a coupon.